Saudi Arabia is launching a Saudi Riyadh 3 trillion, which is equal to $800 billion, plan to double the size of Riyadh in the next decade and transform it into an economic, social and cultural hub for the region.
الرياض مثل ما ذكرت لدولتكم هي تشكل تقريبا 45% من الاقتصاد السعودي وتشكل تقريبا اكثر من 30% من سكان المملكه العربيه السعوديه ولديها بنيه تحتيه متميزه تستطيع ان تستوعب في العشر سنوات القادمه من 15 مليون الى 20 مليون فمعناته هي الرياض احد الممكنات الرئيسيه للنمو الاقتصادي في المملكه العربيه السعوديه وخلق الوظائف. الرياض لديها كل المكونات الاقتصاديه للنجاح، لديها 7 مليون ونصف نسمه، يوجد فيها انفاق عالي، يوجد فيها رؤوس اموال ضخمه، يوجد فيها بنيه تحتيه تكاد تكون من اميز 10 بنى تحتيه لمدن في العالم، فكل هذه ممكنات ان تجعلنا نخلق نمو كبير جدا في مدينه الرياض.
So, where does Riyadh Metro Project stand after these important announcements? Hello everyone, I'm Will Wright, resident engineer with RMTC at the iconic station of Olaya, and I'm going to show you the project and who RMTC is. Riyadh Metro is a rail transportation mega project in the capital city of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. This once in a generation greenfield metro project is the largest transit capital expenditure program ever launched in the kingdom. The project consists of the design and construction of 6 train lines with 86 high-quality stations intended to be key transit collection centers for intermodal connectivity along an alignment of 176 kilometers in the city of Riyadh, 60 kilometers of tunneling, 36 kilometers of at grade, and finally, 80 kilometers of elevated stations. Over 27 billion US dollars. This is Riyadh Metro's current value, the largest design-build metropolitan transit program initiated at one time. Parsons, with a continuous presence in Saudi Arabia since 1958 and many projects, has been proud to be a key player participating in the implementation of the Metro project. Parsons serves as the lead consultant in the Riyadh Metro Transit Consultants, RMTC, consortium teaming with Aegis Rail and Sistra. In 2013, RMTC was selected by RCRC to manage 2 design-build contracts, Package 1 and Package 2, with 3 rail lines and a combined current contract scope value of over 17.5 billion US dollars, which is 65% of the overall metro investment. Contract Package 1, consisting of the design and construction of Lines 1 and 2, was awarded to the BACS Consortium, made up of industry's leading contractors, Bechtel, Almabani, CCC, and Siemens, with the current contract value exceeding just over 11 billion US dollars. Line 1 alignment runs north to south through the heart of the city. Line 1 consists of mostly below grade and elevated rail lines due to the dense nature of a thriving city. Line 1 covers 38 kilometers with 24 stations, 2 rail depots, and 3 park and ride facilities. Line 1 is the spine of Riyadh Metro, where the main transfer stations intersect with Line 4 and Line 6 at the King Abdullah Financial District iconic station designed by Zaha Hadid Architects, which is also the emblem of the Riyadh Metro. Along the 40 kilometers alignment of Line 1, the public streetscape was totally reconstructed, providing an improved and enhanced public space, not only streetscape along the Olaya Bata corridor. The application of the new design transformed Riyadh to a beautiful modern city. Line 2 alignment runs east to west along the King Abdullah traffic corridor, serving government and educational institutions. Line 2 consists of mostly elevated rail lines and covers 25 kilometers with 14 rail stations, 1 rail depot, 1 park and ride facility, and 5 kilometers of improved and enhanced public space streetscape along the King Abdullah corridor. Contract Package 2, consisting of the work for Line 3, was awarded to A&M in 2013 and has a current contract value of $6.42 billion U.S. dollars. Line 3 alignment runs east to west through the very densely populated southern industrial section of the city. Line 3 consists of a combination of at-grade, elevated, and below-grade lines. Line 3 covers 42 kilometers with 22 rail stations, 2 rail depots, 4 park and ride facilities, and 42 kilometers of improved and enhanced public space streetscape along the southern section of the city. Line 3 work also includes 2 iconic stations designed by internationally rail-renowned firms, Snohéta and Amrania. The downtown station is a unique station, which is a real technical challenge with the design and construction of the dome-shaped roof of the iconic Qasr al-Hukm station. Something similar is existing only in Chicago Cloud Gate, but this dome has never been built so big. RCRC has been an excellent client that fully understood that their lack of experience with a program of this magnitude and complexity needed a world-class engineer that would guide them along the way. The excellent relationship between RCRC and RMTC was an excellent demonstration of the one-team concept. From the very beginning of the engineering teams began tackling some of the most difficult issues of developing designs that were integrated into a mature city's existing infrastructure. RMTC, with nearly 100 experienced and specialized designers, reviewed and approved more than 60,000 design documents, drawings, and material submissions. Many times, the technical challenges were standing like a barrier to progress. RMTC's highly experienced design and construction experts, who with innovation and creativity assisted the design build teams through over-the-shoulder design reviews, value engineering assessments, and constructible solutions, unlocked the progress. At the same time, RMTC construction teams with more than 260 inspectors, engineers, and resident engineers were supervising 150 work sites performing more than 683,000 inspections. There were many construction challenges, including working in a live and functioning city center, thousands of meters of utility diversions, and construction of new networks due to metro works, traffic detours, and interfaces with hundreds of stakeholders, public and private, who were done successfully minimizing the impact of the works. Metro quality has been a key focus for Parsons and RMTC to ensure that the contractor's work consistently meets the contract requirements and expectations in the successful delivery of a high-end metro network. Initially, due to the rigorous requirements, the capabilities of the contractor's suppliers, subcontractors, and vendors were stretched beyond their levels of competence. However, in the process of ensuring the highest level of quality, the subcontractors, suppliers, and vendors grew developing capabilities that have boosted their level of competence within the industry, and many have already ventured out and exported their products and services. Parsons clearly understood the value of developing young, emerging Saudi professionals through programs focused on national growth through professional development. The concept of actively promoting Saudization through mentoring and training programs was embraced by RMTC with our Junior Engineer Education Program, JEEP. JEEP focused on the development of Saudi graduates, incorporating them in multinational experienced teams, preparing them to be the future leaders in their career fields for the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. For the end, I kept the best. Parsons is paying extra attention for safety at all of its projects in the world. The safety data for Riyadh Metro Project is really amazing. Look at these figures. 1,393 days without lost time injury as of September 26, 2021. More than 900 million man hours for the entire project, where 690 million is for Package 1 and Package 2. More than 900 million man hours for the entire project. And please, see the comparison for concrete and steel. All of these numbers make the Riyadh Metro perhaps the largest project in the world. But for us, for Parsons, for RMTC, what makes the difference is not the magnitude of the project, but the safety record we jointly achieve. Lost time injury rate for the project reached the industry standard in 2016. It's the dashed yellow line, which is 0.06. After a coordinated effort, we managed to have an LTI less than one-third of the industry standard for four consecutive years, even lower than Parsons Middle East target, which is 0.04. This remarkable record is a reflection of the expressed commitment to everyone's health and safety from all 457 RMTC employees. A true team effort in safety. A team effort with all the contractors and client staff. RMTC was the bonding agent. A safe work environment does not just happen. It is a direct result of commitment and leadership. RMTC set the vision to drive a culture of high health and safety standards since the very beginning that have made a difference. It was not easy at all. RMTC had to push everyone, each and every worker in that project, to motivate them and encourage them for improvement. RMTC launched the Hazard School in 2017 to assist the safety program on the sites and practical hazard analysis. Promoted safety through a rewards and recognition program, which are awarded on a quarterly basis. More than 2,400 different health, safety, and environment training sessions were completed in 2017. RMTC established the 5-star safety award, which soon became the project's top award, with a gentle competition among 150 sites, motivating everyone so that their site will be awarded as the best site on the Metro on a monthly basis. Parsons is proud to have played a key role in implementation of this world-class project. The people of Riyadh and economic growth of Saudi Arabia will benefit in generations to come from the high quality.